Hey guys, thank you so much for tuning in. If you're new here, thank you. Please don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you know when I post. And for those of you who've been here before, thank you. I really appreciate everybody that takes the time out to look at my channel. As you know, I'm trying to grow it. So I wanted to share this with you today. I did do a Pilates class. It's not my first time, it's actually my second. And the first time I did it, we kind of did a mixture of different things. But in this class today, it was mostly focused on getting a good stretch, because throughout the week I am lifting heavy weights. I'm just dealing with a whole lot throughout the week. Not only am I working out, but I'm also training, and I am also working at my 9-to-5. I'm also a mom. Like, I have so much things on my plate. I always try to find a way to have time to myself, even throughout the week. But Sunday is really that day for me, and this is the day after the new year, March 20th, the first day of spring. So we'll acknowledge that. Another thing also, I know I told you guys that I wanted to give you a video about my diet, and that video is definitely coming. I'm just trying to get everything together. Basically, the video will be me talking about my transformation that I'm doing. I'm also going to talk about the foods that I eat, how I transitioned, how I'm still transitioning, and ways to make it easier for you. So I just wanted to slide that in there. But back into this class. So Pilates, I'm always willing to learn. I'm actually about to recertify. So in the process of doing that, I'm also going to do my nutrition license, because I have been delving so deep into the nutrition aspect of training. So as I keep stating, when we all went into quarantine, March of 2020, and the gyms closed, one of the things that I had to get familiar with was my body. And I wasn't at all resistant to it. I was actually happy, because from the beginning of my journey, I have always been someone that enjoyed lifting weights. I never really worked with my body, although it's something I do with my clients. I didn't do it to the extent of getting a really good stretch and making sure I'm getting a really good core engagement in a lot of my movements. Like, I really learned a lot about my physical body when we went into quarantine. So now that everything's back open, I want to continue that momentum. So that's what made me do this class on the Pilates, because not only is it helping me to fix my form and balance and things like that, but it's also giving me the stretch that I need. A lot of these movements, some maybe look, it may look easy to some, but just so you know, it's not easy. It's not hard either, but it was a stretch that my body needed. I've been thinking about going to get a massage, because it's been a while, but you know, I don't know. It's not on the top of my to-do list. I'll just say that. I won't make any excuses. It's not on the top of my to-do list. I'm just making sure I get the stretch that I need when I do my workouts and classes like this. I plan on taking another Pilates class where I'll be doing more of a, like a HIIT. It'll kind of be like a HIIT. And I think I'm going to do maybe 2 to 3 of those in a row, because now that it's about to be spring again, I will be working outdoors. Yeah, like, this was something that I really embraced during quarantine, because prior to that, I did not like working out outdoors. So I'm gonna stop talking, and as this video goes, I'm gonna probably speed it up because it's pretty much the same thing. I just wanted to give anybody who's not familiar with Pilates an idea of what you could be doing in the class. And for anybody who is familiar, this is a different, it may be a different aspect of something that you may have done during the Pilates. So, you know, comment below if you have done Pilates. Let me know how your experience was. I'm always looking for new ways to learn in being a trainer. So who knows, maybe a year from now, I might want to become a Pilates instructor. They do have that option at the place where I went to do my Pilates, which is Clubs Pilates in Park Slopes. Shout out to Serena. That's who you keep seeing in the video. She's one of the instructors there, and she does a number of classes. She's the one that did my first class as well. Something that I would consider also with the Pilates is maybe doing it a one-on-one versus a class, because, you know, in New York, we're still, you know, doing limited capacities at the businesses. So in my class, it's a Sunday and it's only me and one other person, and it's not bad at all. But, you know, as people get more comfortable, things are going to start to get more crowded. And when I am doing anything, I really like the focus to be on me, because I want to be able to do it right. And if you're having to, you know, assist others, you're going to lack in assisting people who may need it more. And that's also one of the reasons why I haven't really done classes like that, like groups, because I really like to engage with people, and I really like to make sure that a person is getting the most out of their experience with me. What's so ironic about me liking to want people to get the full advantage of an experience with me is that I always say that I don't like people. Now, I'm not sure where that comes from, and I think it mainly stems from me just loving my solitude. Like, I am empathic, so I do pick up energy off of people, and there are a lot of people in this world that walk around in a state of bitterness, sadness, just a lot of things that I can feed off of. And I don't like feeling like that, because I like to, I mean, I have my own things going on in my world, but I never project that onto others. I don't feel. I mean, if you know me and you think I do, let me know. But for the most part, I don't like to project. And a lot of times when we're around different people, we can feed off their energy. Sometimes we can start to adapt that kind of energy as well. So I think that's where that comes from. But for the most part, yeah, I really like to engage with people when we work out together. So hence why I don't really do group workouts, because I'm trying to give a person as much of me as I can, even though that's so much, because I do so many things and I'm just getting started in this world. As old as I am, as I get older, I realize how many more things I need to do while I'm here. So initially, when I started doing fitness, I was approached and asked to be a trainer. I was asked several times by several people to train them and things of that nature. But when someone professionally comes up to you and asks you, it's a little different. They saw something in me that I didn't really see or didn't really acknowledge. So anyway, let's get back to this video. As I was saying before, the class was more about me getting a good stretch, loosening up any of the tight places in my body that I felt needed it throughout my workouts in this week. You know, just getting comfortable and feeling also a little bit of pressure, because you're going to see me get up and go on a machine and that too, the weights can be adjusted. The Pilates is really good. Like, I would recommend anybody to do it. I definitely want to try more classes, different ones, to see how they all play out. But right now my focus is more, I have so much other things that I'm trying to do that I can't really delve too much into the Pilates. So like I said, I'm going to take a couple of more that's going to be cardio HIIT focused. And after that, I feel like the weather is going to start getting a little bit warm out here in New York. So I'll mostly be doing workouts like what I would have been doing in Pilates outside, outdoors. Because Sundays is my days where when I do work out, I'm doing something that's more cardio focused, stretching. So things that I don't do on a day-to-day, I'm going to do when I start working out outside. That's what I'll do. So I'm going to let this play. And if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you want to share it, please do so. I really appreciate it if you do. Somebody else can learn something from this, or they can see what a Pilates experience is like before going to a class if they have it in mind or whatever. And spread love, because it's the Brooklyn way. I'll see you guys on the next video. Bye.